Hi everyone, welcome you all back to the vocabulary class today. So today we're going to talk about the topic for the government and authorities. For this particular topic, if the question is something like this, some observers say that police officers should be recruited from the communities where they work so that they have local knowledge. That means locally you should choose the officer. Other people say no, this is unnecessary. Or not required, undesirable. Where do you stand on this debate? Is local knowledge essential in the modern policing? It's all about the government, the authorities, what law should they pick up the police officers to a particular area? I mean, like from a particular area, or it doesn't matter, all these things, something of this sort, the government and authorities. I'm going to show you a list of words. And for any topic related to government, police, authority, laws, you can make use of these words. And your vocabulary score, that is lexical score, will definitely go up. All are very simple words, but the problem is we don't use them. I like to repeat myself. All are very simple words, trustworthy. But we don't use this word. What we use? Capable of being trusted. Use that word. No? It is of utmost significance, it is paramount. Getting it, we actually don't use these words, but we know the words. Trustworthy, paramount. Devious is, like cunningly clever, used on a negative connotation. Extremely clever. Online criminals today are very devious and use many different hacking methods. All right, this is a new word pronounced as minutiae. Very small sensitive details. Nobody really understands the minutiae of the new tax code. Can I use something like this? Oh, definitely yes. With respect to system, authorities, government, enforcing laws and all, you can use this word. Grievance means a sad thing, an issue which makes people upset or angry for a long time. Some towns in the countryside have a grievance with central government. They're not really happy, they're upset with central government. Sensitivity. There's a very sensitive issue. Teachers should show sensitivity to students who have language difficulties. We will see today in the essay as to how we're going to use these words. To commit a crime, to commit an offense, you don't say you make a crime. People say that you do a crime, you commit a crime, you commit a mistake. Commit is the word that always goes with it. We call them collocations. Informants. Yeah, Nakul, I know all these words. I've watched many movies. Don't tell me this word I know. But use it, no. Use it in the essay. Informers, informants. You'd be knowing the word CBI movies and all those things you would have watched these days. The same word, informants. Any doubts on this? So far, any doubts? No doubts. We will continue. Evidence. Material presented in court to prove that someone is guilty or someone is innocent. Any evidence. A trial means a legal procedure of prosecuting someone. Investigation is a trial. Conviction rate. Someone is accused of being guilty or found to be guilty. He is convicted. Conviction rates. Percentage of accused people who are convicted or found to be guilty. A deterrent. This is a very common word. In this context, you can use this as an avoidance of something. We have a guard dog as a deterrent against thieves who come, especially in the night. Deters. It acts as a deterrent to something. Pay more attention. How to use the word? Look at the spelling again. To something. Deterrent to crime. That's how you use it. Sentencing. Know the meaning of sentencing. The action of telling accused or convicted criminal what the punishment is. To sentence someone, now he would know what punishment he's receiving. What are the punishments? Imprisonment. Or could be a fine. Or could be community service. Anyone knows the meaning of community service? This is also a kind of punishment. Anyone knows the meaning of it? Anybody, you can click on the chat option on the bottom right. Excellent, Abhinay. Unpaid work for the betterment of the community. Okay, you've done this crime, you do community service, you will be perfect, Prashant. Perfect, Harita. Rehabilitated. Community service. Payment by doing punishment, sorry, punishment by doing a manual work for the public. Her community service consisted of cleaning the towns, you know, acting as a scavenger. Rehabilitation. Yes, Nakul, the drug rehabilitation. Rehabilitation with respect to crime is nothing but the person has come out of that particular criminal-minded character. Process of changing a criminal's character so that it does not commit more crimes again. Some prisons use music and drama to rehabilitate offenders. Offender, criminal. Synonyms of the word criminal, offenders. Tendencies. See, I have a tendency to do something. It's an inclination towards something, usually towards a negative connotation. It could be anything, but usually on a negative connotation. Some young people in cities have tendencies towards day crime, tendencies towards vandalism. Graffiti is an art where, you know, that spray and all you do on the wall. Tendencies is usually used on a negative connotation. Know this, I'm telling you, simply you cannot use for everything. All right. Corruption, you know the meaning, bribery. But believe me, bribery and corruption both are different. Corruption is where you break the law. The crime is an official breaks the law to help people who he knows. Bribery is the act of giving money to officials to get something. In a way, both are related. But yes, corruption means breaking the law. It could be anything. Bribery is giving the actual money, the note you will give. All right. To enforce laws. Enforce means to order the laws or declare the laws to the people. We need to enforce few laws so that the corona pandemic can be controlled. Something of, we will again recapitulate in just a while everything I'll just show you. Unequitable can be used in any form of essay, these kind of words, which means unfair. Instead of using the word unfair, you can use unequitable. It is unfair. It is unequitable to arrest young people for speeding. But older people, you arrest him. They have all enough experience. Younger people, leave them. It is really unequitable. Law abiding. Abide means to follow. Law abiding. There's a movie also, Law Abiding Citizen, you can watch from Denzel Washington. Law abiding citizens. Citizens who follow the laws. Transferable skills. Skills which can be transferred. He has so many skills. At a time, he can use this skill, but after half an hour, you can switch to another skills. A person who has multiple skills. Usually police officers or any government official who investigates in the case should have transferable skills is what they say. I have transferable skills, which I can use in both my professional career and my fundraising work for charities. I know a lot of people are getting confused because so many words we are saying. Very soon, I'm going to show you how to apply them in your essays. This is the 7th vocabulary session we're doing. The previous 6 vocabulary sessions are inside the practice materials, whatever we have given inside evaluation, lexical resource. All the previous 6 you have to go through. You will find specific topic-related vocabulary. We call topic-related vocabularies the names. Lateral thinking means creative thinking. Think out of the box. Investigative skills. Someone who doesn't just rely on his kidney, not the heart, not the intuition, who uses his brain and investigate. To transcend, in any case, you can use this in any topic. Even in your speaking, you can use all these words. To transcend means, look at the picture. To go above all these things. That is to transcend. You have something here which transcends above all. You have something at the top which is at the top, which transcends above all. I'll just explain. It is one of the important words. To be bigger or go beyond it. The need for reducing financial waste transcends the government. Everybody should be spending the money more carefully. May not be clear in this example. In the essay, I've got a very good example which will help you understand. To transcend means to overcome, which is above all, which transcends all these things. You have few things here which can transcend all the other negatives. Let's say you have to hire a police officer. If he has skills, that is enough. I don't care where is he from. Is he from this area or some other area? Which country, India or Kenya, I don't care. All it matters is skills. So now skills transcends all other information. It goes above all other. This is most important. That is what transcend means. Over familiarity. When you know someone in person too much, an official is too friendly with the public. Over friendly, over familiarity is the same word. So we saw a few of the words. We'll just check them in this. Just have a look at it on the left, on the right hand screen, my right hand side. This will be there throughout the class. Trustworthy, paramount is something most important. Devious means dishonest or, you know, like extremely cunning in a negative way. Minute, shy, very small details, sensitive details. Grievance means upset, sensitivity. You should be sensitive, I mean, to someone. Sensitivity again, we will just check. Teacher should show sensitivity that, you know, like you should understand the circumstances properly. That sensitivity to commit an offense, informants, evidence, trial, conviction rates. Deterrent means to stop. Sentencing means what kind of punishment a person is going to get. One of the punishment is imprisonment, fine, community service. And when he goes through all these things, he actually rehabilitates. The character of a person changes. Offender is criminal. Tendency is what you have a tendency for, what you like to do something. Corruption, one who breaks the law. Bribery, one who gives money. To enforce the laws, unequitable is fair. Law-abiding, someone who follows the law. Transferable skills, he can switch the skills. Lateral thinking, creative thinking. Investigative skills, someone who has better skills in investigation. To transcend, something that goes above all, over familiarity, over friendly. I know all these things are just running in your mind at the moment. Once I show an essay, probably could be able to relate them clearly. One moment. The same question. Some observers say that police officers should be recruited from the communities where they work. Let's say this is one area A. You should hire the police officers for the A, from the A only. From a B, you don't hire it to A. This is a place, from that place, a locally grown person. He only fits the job properly so that they have local knowledge. But at the same time, there are others who say this is quite unnecessary or even not desirable. Where do you stand on this debate? Is local knowledge essential? Is the question. Let's say you felt local knowledge is essential. Let's see how to start the essay with. The need for effective, good police officer is very much important in society today, especially as criminals become very, very cunningly clever and creative. So regarding whether police should be locally hired, there is a case to be made on both the sides of the debate. This essay will briefly explain both the sides before giving my opinion something. Can anyone quickly tell me for the highlighted words, what word can be replaced? The need for effective, good police officers. I don't need the word good. What word can be used? Believe me, we use these words in the essay when we write. First of all, we have a lot of tremendous pressure going on. We see the timer. Timer is ticking. Ideas are not generated. Kidney, heart, everything has stopped functioning. On top of that, Nakul, good and trustworthy, I don't think I'm gonna use it. Need for effective, trustworthy police officer. Someone who can be trusted is very much important. Is very much important. What other word can be used? Is very much important. Anybody? Perfect, Abhinaya. Hema, perfect. That's all it is. Paramount. Try using it. See, I'm telling you, if you don't use it often, what happens, you know? You just learn and very soon forget. You're happy while learning because, okay, I'm learning something. But soon you're going to forget. You have to start using them. This video will be uploaded. You can check them multiple times, make notes, learn them. And whenever you send us this, right, start using these words. Do not again write very much important. It is very much significant, indispensable. Use the word paramount. Satnam perfect. Charu perfect. Is paramount in society today, especially as criminals become very clever criminals. Negative connotation. Devious. This is the word. Perfect. Girisha perfect. Hansif correct. Fine. So we also will understand a bit of ideation for this. See, now I'm going to show you a few of the vocabulary. I've already showed you a lot, and I'm going to show you how to use them. Once you understand how to use them, all, you know, your write-ups should not be inclined only towards the vocabulary. First thing is idea. Second thing is representation of the idea to the topic. Third thing is the vocabulary. Do not write just because you want to use that word. Write and along, you know, try to use the word if it makes sense. That should be the approach. I know the word, I will write something so that I use the word. It's a wrong approach. Do not do it that way. Some observers say that police officers should be recruited from the communities where they work so that they have local knowledge. Is local knowledge essential? Let's talk about it. I think if you have a person who has some local knowledge, he would know the history of the place. He could show some sensitivity towards the place, understand it, and accordingly enforce the laws and help in a better way. One of the points. We're going to start with it. The need for effective, the same one, trustworthy, paramount, and devious, I changed. Those who support local recruitment of others, local recruitment officers, point to the need for the police to understand every detail of the local community. Those who think that, okay, this police officer should be from this place only, he should be a local guy, because he would know each and everything about the place, what the place has gone through, the history, the sad grievances of the place, everything he would know. For example, a community may have certain frictions, some fights, or a history of specific bad events, where, whether religious, political, otherwise. In such situations, the argument goes that the police need to really understand the situation and also be able to expect what kind of crimes can happen in this place. Correct? Furthermore, local officers may find it easier to gain people who can provide information. He knows every in and out of the place, everyone he knows. He can gain information easily from some person, leading to stronger evidence while interrogating, leading to higher number of people accused of crime. And he blocks the crime or stops the crime from happening through an effective punishment, leading to offender not entering into the crime field again. Now, your job, I have highlighted a lot of words here. All those highlighted words should be changed from this set. Can you guys give it a try? Give it a try. I think many are getting it. Perfect Chichendra, perfect Prashant. Perfect Mini. Harita correct. Perfect Darshana. Perfect Charu. Excellent Rohit. Try, I'm telling you. You have seen the words, try fitting in here, you would know how to use them. Every detail is not evidence. try to get the context. You're talking about very sensitive, minute detail of the society. Perfect, Basil. Not correct. Perfect, Darshana. Mohit, correct. Informants. Every detail will be minutiae. Bad event is grievance. In such situation, the argument goes, the police need to understand the situation. He need to be really, really. Can anyone complete this word? He need to show sensitivity. He should be sensible. He should understand things. Sense, make sense. Sense, use your brain. Sensitivity. Police need to show sensitivity and also should be able to expect the kind of crimes that maybe, don't use the word, I'm telling you, it's a formal writing. Do the crime, don't use the word. Kind of crimes can maybe committed. You commit a mistake, you commit a crime. Perfect, Asif. Furthermore, local officers may find it easier to gain informants. Informants in the community leading to stronger evidence while, what do you call this interrogation? There's a word right over there. At, the word instead of while starts with at. Anybody? The act of interrogating is called trial. Perfect. Investigation is also fine. Interrogating is fine. The actual word is trial. Uma, correct. At trials, higher number of people accused of crime. If someone is accused of crime or, you know, of guilty of committing a crime, what do you call that particular thing? Higher number rate. Conviction rates. Higher conviction rates leading to stronger evidence while, or leading to stronger evidence at trials, higher convicting rates. And when you stop or block the crime from happening, what is the word? I want the complete phrase. Deterrent dash crime. Don't write deterrent from crime. Deter means stop from. What is the word? What is the preposition? Deterrent to crime through an effective punishment. Can you guys tell me what all words you know about punishment? So now this is the chance for you to exhibit your vocabulary. Don't write effective punishment. Instead of that, write the actual word for the punishment. Sentencing, and then Rohit, come on, next. Mini next, sentencing. Imprisonment, perfect, Archana, next. Perfect, Abhinaya. I mean, perfect, Prashant. Fine, community service, use all the words. Lexical resource score just. The graph just goes like this. Because those are the words that actually fits in to this particular essay. Effective punishment, what is that? Or effective punishment, such as leading to the offender not entering into the crime field. Again, do you know when this happens? When you're extremely pressurized. You've taken all the pressure on your shoulders. Mind is not working. Nakul, kidney has stopped, heart has stopped functioning. What is the word for this? Offender not entering into the crime field again. Rehabilitation of the criminal or the offender. No rehabilitation. Pay more attention. That's exactly what it is. Rehabilitation is you changing one's criminal mind to a normal human being or something. With respect to the law, this is, I mean, that's what it means, rehabilitation. The process of changing a criminal's character so that he does not commit more crimes. To rehabilitate someone. Getting it? Rajendra, perfect. Let's see the same essay. I've written it here. Every detail, the minutiae of the local community. Why you need to go for a local guy? Because he would know each and everything about the local place. We call minutiae. See, just knowing the word is not enough. Spelling has to be correct. If you've written a wrong spelling, then a person would not read it as minutiae. Be careful. Otherwise, don't use. Don't use wrong things. Your marks will go down. If you're using this, you are preparation should be 100% perfect. Use the correct word, T-I-E-E, little difficult. Or you use minute details if you're finding the word difficult. For example, community may have certain frictions or a history of a specific bad event. Some events which upsets that particular event to show sensitivity, understand the situation, crimes that may be committed. Informants, trials, higher conviction rates, and a deterrent to crime through punishment, sentencing, imprisonment, fines, or community service, which further leads to rehabilitation of the offender. Any doubts? A very simple one. How we did? Yes, Nakul, we wrote all the words first and then decided to write some sentences using the words. No. Again, I'm telling you, this may happen to you sooner or later. If you're doing that, that's a wrong approach. Don't think about the words first. Know the words. Words is like a knowledge. While executing, whenever you want to pick, it's not like, okay, I have the words, I will pick them and make sentence. No, the other way. Have an idea, execute them, write them accordingly, you know, to the task response, coherence, cohesion, grammar, lexical resource. If you want that word, if you think the word is fitting in, you use it. If you're really getting confused, then in the computer-based, you can write like this and then change it by clicking the backspace button. In the paper-based, you can't. You can't keep on erasing every time. It looks ugly. The paper might be thrown into a trash later. In the computer-based, you have this. You write whatever you want and then change it. In the paper-based, this doesn't look practical. Okay. In the paper-based, all these things should happen in your mind. Before writing done, you should put that write, I mean, that done D-O-N-E in your mind. And then while writing, you should change the word done to committed. It's up to you how you do it, but practice while you are with us and send us for the feedback. Well, fine. We will continue. On the other hand, what other people think? If you are a local guy, he would know all the politicians, everyone. He will take money, bribe, everything. It is not good to have a local guy in the local area. That's the only point. It seems he can be influenced as well. It seems likely that officers from the community may in fact have similar inclinations as the other people they grew up with. Similar inclination means similar tendencies, similar intentions, similar desires. The lot of people who are bribed, this person will also grow the same way. For example, in countries such as Mexico, we see a high incidence of corruption among the local business and government community, local business and the government community, which is equal by corruption. I can use the word bribery by among the police. A second objection is that local sensitivity may lead to the police failing to use the laws fully and effectively making exceptions for some offenders. Definitely true. What a good point, which is not for the citizens who follow the laws, which is not fair. The word is missing here, very sorry, which is not fair for the word fair is missing, very sorry on this here, fair should come, which is not fair for the citizens who follow the laws. Can anyone write the complete sentence, which is, I don't want to use the word not fair. Effectively making exceptions for some offenders, which is, anybody? Not fair. Unequitable for the law-abiding citizens. Try using the words, don't forget, not fair, unfair is unequitable, which is unequitable for the law-abiding citizens, people who follow the laws. Don't use for citizens who follow the laws, which is not fair or unequitable for the law-abiding citizens. Finally, here the point ends. And now we say, finally, it doesn't have to do anything with the location as long as the police has kidney. Correct? Finally, we must remember that police officers should have certain skills and the ability to investigate. What skills? Creative skills, investigative skills, lateral skills, or transferable skills. transferable skills, which should certainly go beyond their background or the environment they're working in. Pay attention to the word go beyond. We must remember that police officers should have skills, blah, blah, blah skills, which should or which certainly goes beyond their background, environment, personality, blah, 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 blah. All these do not matter. What matters is their skills. The skills is above all this to transcend. Perfect, Roy. Perfect, Mini. Is getting it? Try using the word. See, I have used all the simple words that we use in our essay. That goes beyond everything. We use this simple, simple sentence that transcends everything. This is what you learn. This is what you don't forget. I'm again telling you, forgetting is very simple. Very, very, learning is difficult. Because when you learn, you're not supposed to forget. If you're forgetting it, you're not learning it. You are just listening through this ear and leaving it in another ear. Write it down. You need to make use of these words whenever or wherever situation demands. Simple one. Inclination becomes tendencies of the people, desires. Corruption becomes bribery. A second objection is to use the laws fully, to enforce the laws. Problem is that they need to declare or enforce the laws. That means the law should be reachable to everyone. Everyone should abide by the law. Effectively making exceptions, which is unfair, unequitable for the citizens who follow for our law towards law-abiding citizens. Their transferable skills, lateral thinking, investigative ability, which should transcend their background or everything that comes in between. Skill is the most paramount thing. The rest of them are not. This transcend, which goes beyond everything. Any doubts? Yes, law-abiding people. Law-abiding who follow. Abide means to follow. Citizens you have to use, or some people, individuals, public, something you have to use, right? Any doubts? Okay, so far we have got some knowledge. A lot of words are literally running through your mind. So let me take up another essay and make you guys write. So overall, it seems to me that local knowledge is not absolutely essential, because skills are the one that transcends beyond, you know, everything, whose skills should be effective in any context. Indeed, I agree with those who say that risks of local recruitment outweigh its benefits, because the danger of corruption and over-familiarity with potential offenders. We're just making use of the words we know. When a topic comes, something like this comes, or for example, school topic came with respect to subjects. Can you guys quickly list, people who are here for some time now, can you guys quickly list what are all the words that can be used here? School, children, education, subjects. Harita, have you finished the video? People who have gone through the video or the live class? Anyone, please? Syllabus, curriculum, academic. Another word? Pedagogy, pedagogical experts. And then teacher. These are the simple words. So these kind of words you can use for any essay related to teacher, subjects, education, guided learning, excellent, Amna. So when the video has already been made, kindly look into that. It gives you some more than 30 words, which you can use it in your speaking as well. The same way here, these set of words, we're going to use it in this essay also. Some people think that government should be responsible for crime prevention. Something about law authority, I am going to use this because I know them how to use. Well, others believe No, government responsibility. It is not government responsibility to prevent the crime. It is responsibility of individuals to protect themselves. Discuss both sides. Pay more attention to the question. Rote learning. Thanks, Mini. What is rote learning? We all have done this. I have done this till my 7th standard. What is rote learning? Repetitive, memorizing things. Just repetition again and again and again. Memorize and learn. Okay, all right. Again, I read the question. Some people think that government should be responsible. Pay more attention to every word for crime prevention. While others believe it is a responsibility of the individual to protect themselves. Discuss both the sides and give your opinion. I'm gonna give you hints. What do you call the ideas? I'm gonna give you, and I want you guys to write it for second para. Second, okay, see here, introduction, body one, body two, conclusion. Now we are all writing body one. Don't write, please have patience. I'm gonna show you. Body one, I'm gonna show you now some ideas with respect to why government should be responsible for crime prevention. Body two will be, it is a responsibility of every individual to protect. Conclusion is different. Now we are all writing body one, okay? This is what I've given. I'll not explain anything. This is what I've given. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. As many people as possible, kindly write. Type and enter in the chat box. If you're writing on a notebook, you can WhatsApp me. I'm going to check it later. I want the complete, this complete paragraph of the second para. Complete sentences of second. Don't write one or two lines. I want the complete para. And your idea should be dependent on this. We need to depend on someone, man. Government should be responsible. It can make laws. It can appoint officers who are trained and everything goes in a systematic way. However, if we try to do it in our sense, we may misuse the law. Hey, I have every, you know, like right to kill someone if you make a mistake. So I will kill you even if you don't make a mistake. If you may misuse the law. Everything I've written, second paragraph, kindly write. I'm gonna give you 5 minutes. guys, pay attention. All I want is not just write, but try to make at least some 3 to 4 words from this. That is the whole idea. Minimum 3 to 4 words I need. Good one, Rohit. Could have been improved, but still a good one, Rohit. You have written a very good one, Kanchan. Continue writing it. Rohit, you've written systematic way, no? Explain that. You can use the word trials, imprisonment, fine, community service, rehabilitation, offender, corruption, bribery. Every word you can use. If you explain, can provide a systematic way to handle crimes. For example, you can use all these words and increase your lexical resource scores. Prashant, good one, but continue. I want more of it. No, you don't give paramount to the government. In this way, you could have modified it, Prashant. Every individual. Okay, let's take Ravi Tejas. Every individual has to, not have to. Every individual has to depend on environment when we are living in society. Can anyone correct this? I did not change everything, Prashant. Can anyone correct this? On one hand, every individual has to depend on the government when we are living in society. Individual, we cannot come. What can be used here? It's very simple. You just have to remove few words. That's all. When living in society, when VR is not required, Vedeja. No, see, has to depend is not the question. Should we depend? So every individual. Okay, let's continue. Government is responsible to protect and ensure every citizen is safe. Due to rise in conviction rates and corrections, government is appointing numerous trained armed guard for people to provide the law systematically spelling wrong. The Bharat Mission has appointed a certain police force with certain. No, see, guys, pay attention, kindly pay attention. So this is off topic. The points are good, but it is not representing the topic. The question is, is government responsible? Here it is written, what are the responsibilities of the government? The question is not, what are the responsibilities of the government? Using the same words, you can represent it saying, therefore, government should be responsible to prevent the crimes. We need someone to depend on, and government only has the authority to make the laws and can appoint good officers, and everything can go in a systematic way, bringing justice to the public. On the other hand, if the responsibility is shared with the individuals, then individuals may use the law in their hands and may commit heinous crimes. Therefore, it should be the sole responsibility of the government for the crime prevention, to prevent crime. Are we getting it? So what you have written, the responsibility. So what can government do? The question is different. Okay, we'll take Darshanas, and then we're gonna talk about the essay and then wind up the class. On the contrary, government has the ability to enforce laws and has authority to achieve it. Since if these authorities are provided to the citizens of the country, comma, they might misuse the laws and can commit a serious crime in order to protect themselves. If there is no law abiding by the people, if I'm not understanding this, then is wrong, then the officials have the power to imprison the individual. Therefore, this makes us depend on the government to have a systematic way to confront. Not clear with this, Darshana. Could I have written in a much clearer way? I'm going to show you the similar one I have written. Kanchan, you can just WhatsApp me later. This is a very big one. Fine, guys. So this is what I have written. What I have done, I've tried to use the words because I've learned some words. I'm paying conscious attention to the vocabulary as well. Everyone cannot be independent and has to rely on some source for their safety. As the governing body, comma, government alone has the supreme power to enforce laws or regulations depending on the intensity of the crime, and only the trained professionals possess investigative skills to carry trials, declare sentences, or a fine. These set of predefined procedures, predefined procedures provide or give the law-abiding citizens a ray of hope that upper hands are visible. Upper hands are, because I tried using the word, I could not, I was, before signing the meeting, I was writing this, visible, hands are visible for the safety of the public and act as a deterrent to crime in a systematic way. On the other hand, if individuals are given full responsibility, they may take the laws in their hands to respond to the devious crime and misuse it. See, wherever is possible, I am trying to use it. No, Nakul, it is so difficult. It is difficult. Who is saying it's very easy? But it's not impossible. You just have to believe it is possible, have that hope, and keep trying. In other words, try using them. The flow will come. The flow will come. Try using them, flow will come. But people will completely forget this and only think of idea and finishing them. Idea is fine. You have gotten that. That was what I was trying to explain. You have got the idea. Try mixing at least some 3 to 4 words. All right. Yes, heinous crime also you can use. By the way, the word heinous is this. Okay. The same with the last paragraph I'm going to show you. On the other hand, there are a number of police officers who are corrupted and often make exceptions to offenders. This is not only unequitable, unfair to the law-abiding citizens, comma, but also people, or it loses the hopes on the government authorities. Therefore, instead of, or rather than, both the words you can use there, depending on the administration, it should become the responsibility of the individuals to fight for their safety. Now throw an example. In Japan or China, they have kung fu, that this martial art, for the same reason. In Japan and many other countries, almost every adolescent possesses martial arts skills and protect themselves during any thefts or crime, and do not completely depend on the government for petty crimes. You can use the word. And then give your opinion. Now you discussed both, now you should give the opinion. Overall, in my opinion, write what is your opinion. But before that, probably you could have written here, in Japan, blah, 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 one line here. However, it also depends on the intensity of the crime. If the crime is very deep, if it's a very big crime, probably individuals cannot defend themselves. Overall, though there are equal arguments available on both sides, I believe that government should be responsible because it has to happen in a systematic way. And if it is given to us, we may misuse it. Getting it? That's how you finish this. So opinion is very much important. We can say shared responsibility. Yes, definitely. Opinion, whatever the opinion you want to give, I mean, whatever you want, you can give, no problem. But simply don't write something new. Whatever you've written above, incline your opinion towards the rest of the essay you have written. That attracts more marks. Here you write government not responsible at all. Opinion you wrote, government should be responsible. Then it doesn't make sense. Any doubts, guys? So I'm again telling you, it's not just the knowledge, it's execution. You have got the knowledge of a lot of words. Now how to use them? Even in your speaking, you can make use of these words. Okay. All right, Amna. We shall do the next session based on art. I think art we have done, and I don't remember. We'll do it or not. Fine, guys. Saying this, we'll park it here. The next class is going to be 18th of January, listening LIMOC, 9 p.m. Indian time. I'm going to catch you. Till then, take care. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.